Today's proclamation of the Word of God is in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 12. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, you dwell in the midst of a rebellious house, which has eyes to see, but does not see, and ears to hear, but does not hear. For they are a rebellious house. Therefore, son of man, prepare your belongings for captivity, and go into captivity by day in their sight. You shall go from your place into captivity to another place in their sight. It may be that they will consider, though they are a rebellious house. By day, you shall say, bring out your belongings in their sight, as though going into captivity. And at evening, you shall go into their sight like those who go into captivity. Dig through the wall in their sight and carry your belongings out through it. And their sight, you shall bear them out of your shoulders and carry them out at twilight. You shall cover your face so that you cannot see the ground, for I have made it you sign to the house of Israel. So I did as I commanded. I brought out my belongings by day, as though going into captivity, and at evening I dug through the wall with my hand. I brought them out at twilight and bore them on my shoulder in their sight. And in the morning, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, has not the house of Israel, the rebellious house, said to you, What are you doing? Say to them, Thus says the Lord God, This burden concerns the prince in Jerusalem, and all the house of Israel, who are among them. Say, I am saying to you, as I have done, you shall see it to be done in them. They shall be carried away into captivity. And the prince who is among them shall bear his belongings on his shoulder at twilight, and go out they shall dug through the wall that carried them out through it. He shall cover his face so that he cannot see the ground with his eyes. The word of the Lord. Please stand for our responsorial psalm. Psalm 78. And let our response be, Do not forget the works of the Lord. Altogether, do not forget the works of the Lord. Yet they tested and provoked the Most High God, and did not keep his testimonies, but turned back and acted unfaithfully like their fathers. They were turned aside like deceitful bough. Response. For they provoke him to anger with their high places, and move him to jealousy with their carved images. When God heard this, he was furious, and greatly abhorred Israel. Response.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
And delivered his strength into captivity, and his glory into the enemy's hand. He also gave his people over to the sword, and was furious with his inheritance. Response.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, chapter 18. We're reading the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18, beginning from verse 21 up to chapter 19, verse 1. Then Peter came to him and said, Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me? And I forgive him up to 7 times. Jesus said to him, I do not say to you up to 7 times, but up to 70 times 7. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a certain king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. And when he had begun to settle accounts, one was brought to him who owed him 10,000 talents. But as he was not able to pay, his master commanded that he be sold with his wife and children and all that he had, and that payment be made. The servant therefore fell down before him, saying, Master, have patience with me, and I will pay you all. Then the master of the servants was moved with compassion, released him, and forgave him the debts. But that master went out and found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii. And he laid hand on him and took him by the throat, saying, Pay what you owed. So his fellow servant fell down at his feet and begged him, saying, Have patience with me, and I will pay you all. And he would not, but went and threw him into the prison till he should pay the debts. So when his fellow servants saw what he had done, they were very grieved and came and told their master all that had been done. Then his master, after he had called him, said to him, You wicked servant, I forgave you all the debt because you begged me. Should you not also have had compassion on your fellow servant, just as I have pity on you? And his master was angry and delivered him to the torturers until he should pay all that was due to him. So my heavenly Father also will do to you if each of you from his heart do not forgive his brother his trespasses. Now it came to pass, when Jesus had finished these sayings, that he departed from Galilee and came to the region of Judea beyond the Jordan. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Good morning. Once again, sa aton nga Gospel Diaro. Unmerciful servant. Sa ato nga ng gospel, si Peter na pangutan na, pila nga times magkasaga ka akong akong nga brother, aga akong patawaron? 7 times? Unamat, may una nga nakita, may nabatian akong tao. Uman na pa, pangatlo. May ana ba yung kutod? May kutod. But Jesus, may kutod ro, ana ba yung mercy? Anang pagpatawad? But Jesus said, wamanan ako na hambaga nga 7 times, but 70 times 7. Di ka na natin makita. nga sayod nato na story yun yara. But sa ato niya times makaroon. Kata mamakita kung ano rung pagigugma it Diyos katon. Whatsoever nga ginhimo naton nga mga saya. Bisan ano kadagom nga saya. If ratong heart o narong repentance pag hinusol wagin nagabalibad dato niya Diyos Ama para patawaron kita. For forgiveness itato niya Ama is no boundaries. Hasta nagapangayo kita, magkumitar kita makaron, magkumitar kita manganangan, magkumitar kita mga saga, padayon nga forgiveness it Diyos igatao gidanana katon kung kita nagapatawad. Pero rikara, pro isyo, nga sayang ka-servant, ngayong patawad sa anang master, sa anang mga utang. Tag-imaw yun, pero nakita na ng fellow servant nga may utang ka na, bukong tayo merciful, anang gingkitis, pero raya nga anang fellow servant. Wana na na dumdumi nga masubra para ng utang sa anang master nga ginduya yon. Raya nga 100 denari, hindi na na mapatawad, hindi na na mabaton nga, hindi mo pagabayaran. Hindi kararaton nga reminder. Reminder ka ton nga, yes, abo kita nga naghimo ka ton it mga masakit sa atong buot, mga naka-offend katon. But di ka ragi na remind katon whatsoever nga doyon abi hay kalisod naton i-release ng forgiveness. Kalisod naton maitaorong forgiveness dahil may unang dahambay, tabo malang ako. But Jesus said nga 70 times 7 forgiveness, dapat natin i-release others. Agrikara natin. Aton man, kung kita, ano kadagom, ado kabo, rato nga ginhimo nga saga sa Diyos, assured kita ngin patawad, bangod kay Jesus. Di ka naman, sa aton man, nga party, nga reminder ka aton, nga mag-hold kita it forgiveness sa nag-offend ka ton. Di natin pag-release of forgiveness. Apektado raton nga pagpangabuhi. Apektado ratong emotion, apektado atong feelings. Mas apektado ratong spiritual life. And peace. Bukon kita at peace. Hindi kita mapakali. To forgive others is malisod, but let us do, bangod. Hambay ya sa verse 35 that if you do not forgive, the Father also will not forgive you. Reminder for us. Release forgiveness to others. When God forgive us, we remember what God has done, what Jesus has done, His love. Also, if we have love of God, we can do to forgive others. Forgive others, give gitao katot peace. Amen?